In today's brief, after receiving massive criticism from all over the country, Kerala Chief Minister Pinarayi Vijayan has announced that his government will not implement the controversial provision Section 118A of Kerala Police Act 2011 in its present form. The offence of intimidation, defamation or insulting of any person through social media was inserted in Kerala Police Act by way of an ordinance on Saturday. A batch PIs have also been filed before the Kerala High Court challenging the constitutional validity of the said provision. Moving further, the Supreme Court on Monday observed that the pandemic situation is likely to worsen across the country in coming months and the states as well as the centre must be well equipped to deal with the COVID-19 crisis. The court directed the states of Delhi, Maharashtra, Gujarat and Assam to file status report with respect to COVID-19 cases in respective states, the ground situation for handling crisis as well as the steps taken. The Supreme Court today extended the parole by a week of A.G. Perarivalan, a convict in 1991 assassination of former Prime Minister Rajiv Gandhi, and has directed the state of Tamil Nadu to provide an escort for his medical checks. The matter will now be heard for final disposal on the next date. Moving further, the Delhi High Court today directed the Union of India to consider as a representation a PIL filed by Delhi Labour Union seeking period leave and facilities of periodic rests, separate and clean toilets and provision of sanitary napkin to women employees during menstruation period. In a recent development, the Delhi Police on Sunday filed a 930-page supplementary charge sheet under Section 13, Unlawful Activities, Section 16, Terrorist Act, Section 17, Raising Funds for Terrorist Act, and 18, Conspiracy of Draconian UAPA and other relevant sections of IPC, Arms Act and Prevention of Damage to Public Properties Act against Umar Khalid and Shahjul Imam. The offences entail a maximum punishment of death penalty.